tester.co.uk.
Hello YouTubers and welcome to this T4D. Now there's a fair bit to cover off in this T4D, some news, some bits and pieces to unbox which I'm going to reveal now. So I have my notes at hand because there's a fair bit to remember. I'll just show you literally before I came into the lab to start this T4D, I wasn't quite expecting it this soon, but a box has arrived from Barry from tester.co.uk. I'll just pull you down here. As you can see, it's a rather large box and I've got a rough idea of what's in the box. Barry sent me a list of about 40 Unity products. And he kind of said, you know, what would you like to review? So I picked out a few and he did say, look, no, you can have the whole list. So he was willing to send me 40 items which remain mine after I've done the review. We then obviously said, look, I'm just about to go to the States, so it's pointless me receiving 40 items here. So I picked a few key items and they are in this box. So we will kind of unpack this box together just to show you what I've chosen. Ultimately, I think some of the items in here, once the review has been done, may not be the best. And that's what we want to unearth. Barry's keen to understand what products are going to work for them on their site and what aren't. So this is part of the process. So we'll jump into the box and unearth what's here. And those reviews will be coming up over the next couple of weeks. Then the most important thing we want to jump into on this review is that the portable dog killer or canine quieter or hush puppy competition has come to an end. So first of all, an acknowledgement to Steve Gibson, who originally came up with this idea when he was at school, and the whole idea to bring it to life again was to inspire people just to get out there and try something. Doesn't matter if it fails or works, it's just a case of experimentation. And as I said in a previous T4D, I've been bowled over just by your efforts. What you've posted, the collaboration has been absolutely brilliant. And again, to date, it's come to an end. And as far as I can see, looking at the posts on my forum, there have been no real successful items, no successful units produced, but I can tell a lot of fun has been had along the way. Some interesting videos. So hats off to all you guys. If you entered the competition and didn't manage to get to the end where you presented something, I still thank you for entering and appreciate that. Those of you who have got to the end and presented where you've got to, I'd say still, once this competition is over, I'm still going to love, we're all going to enjoy following your posts and any progress you make to kind of get an end result where you might have a working solution. But so what's going to happen now, as I said, I'm going to open my forum up so that even guests are able to see attachments and videos and what have you. So I'll post a link below to the whole thread where you can see the end where they and people initially entered and where they go and present their final project. And as I said, there's no real criteria. You can judge it how you wish. All I want you to do is go and have a look, read through, pick who you choose as your winner, and then note therefore that the members have a forum name. So you'll see from their post they've got a forum name. Post that name under this video. So for the next week, that's when judging takes place. And I'd urge as many of you as possible. I'd like to see a fair number of people judging in this. Post the name of the forum member who you would like, that's your choice as the winner. I will then add up all the votes, and then the forum member that gets the most votes, that's the winner. The member that gets the second number of votes will be the runner-up. If there's a tie, well then we'll look at that situation and we'll deal with that as it arrives. But anyway, for the next week, I ask you to do that. And again, thank you very much. Then also what I do want to note, and it's a big thank you to Barry again for, you know, sending all this kit and being a sponsor and keeping this show on the road. I'm now tester.co.uk's first affiliate. So if you look below, on the links to their sites, you'll see it's a longer URL because there's an affiliate code. And if you click on that, if you go to their website and then either immediately or later on go and buy, purchase something there, that purchase is attributed to me and I earn a commission. So what I'm, going forwards, for the most part, if I review something, I will perhaps be referring to that item that you can purchase on tester.co.uk. If they don't have it for some reason, then I'll obviously refer to the Amazon. Most of the items I review will be on Amazon as well. So ultimately, you have the choice. Maybe the shipping and the pricing might be better on Amazon. Let me know, because then perhaps Barry can try and compete with that. But otherwise, there'll be a choice. But I'll often link to where I can to the equipment on tester.co.uk. And to that part as well, what Barry's actually done, it's the only thing I've pulled out of this box, because I haven't pulled out the rest of the stuff. He's produced these boards, which I'll be using, or these mats, which I'll be using when I actually do reviews of his equipment. And let me just explain the reason and the rationale behind that. For one, quite obviously, advertising. It's brand awareness. Two, and most, almost as important, is that as I found one of my very keen-eyed viewers here has at least on two occasions pointed out where someone else has gone and either stolen images or my video itself and used it on their channel to try and sell equipment. I think one of those cases, like one of the Agilent reviews I did, someone took a snippet, a picture from my review and was then using that to sell the equipment. And obviously that's not really on, and that's a problem that tester.co.uk face as well. If they often take photographs of equipment, people will then go and nab those pictures, and they don't want that happening to their to the video reviews. So the video reviews is specifically for Tester will be done on that mat, so that it makes it a little less easier for someone to go and steal the actual footage and use it. Right, then also a bit of news on the website for the multimeter reviews or the multimeter buyer's guide. Some progress has been made. There's a very kind gent based in Durban, South Africa. It's not Sean B. Sean B is also a very kind viewer of mine, but there's another gent. I won't name him yet because he kind of hasn't said I can use his name, but I certainly will. He will probably have his name and his details on the website once I've got it published. But there is progress. I need to now go in to the work that he's done, kind of see how well it works, the functionality, and start posting data there. It's going to take time. My time is very tight at the moment. So, but over the next few weeks, hopefully, ideally hope before I leave for the States that I'll have that website up, but it will happen in time. So there'll be a website up with links to the video reviews and all the kind of specifications and a nice selection tool to go and sort multimeters and that kind of thing. So that is happening as well. I have then also this morning, after posting the video review of the Agilent U1232A, I have contacted RS Components again and pointed them to the video and saying, look, you're not doing any yourselves any favors in terms of the marketing of this. If you're taking that long to produce the kind of Bluetooth data logging module. So they have said they promise they are actioning it, they're going to get it to me. I'm going to do part two today, in fact, after this video will be the teardown and the further testing of this, and then hopefully part three will be where we have a look at the actual data logging with that Bluetooth module. At the moment, this multimeter, if you want to buy it, if you look at the review, there's a link to my Amazon store. Barry is looking at becoming an agent for Agilent as well, so keep an eye open for that in the future. He will hopefully be stocking Agilent equipment, and then obviously I'll be referring to his to tester.co.uk for that kit as well. Right, then another thing I want to highlight, as I said, the one thing I do want to promote is other people with channels who are getting into this. Now, there's a gent who follows my channel, and he sent me an email with saying that he had been inspired by myself and other channels to set up his own YouTube channel and kind of do DIY videos. Now, he calls it My Days of Projects, and the one he linked to that I went to have a look at was he was providing a how to find a stud in a wall. So obviously in the States, where obviously you have a lot of partitioning and what have you in your houses, it's a bit different in here in South Africa. We've got brick and mortar, but there I know you've got studs. I know I had the same fun and games when I was living there, and I'll have the same again. But he does this video on how to find it acoustically by tapping and then using a stud finder tool. But then he also goes into an explanation of how that stud finder tool works by capacitance. So I just say hats off to anyone who's kind of jumping into this kind of business and doing this. And I'm going to link to the video here so that you can go and watch it. And I'd say it's certainly worthwhile if DIY and that kind of thing is your interest, then it's worthwhile subscribing to his channel to allow him to grow, because I certainly do appreciate his efforts and I certainly like the way he presents his videos. Right, then also some feedback on the battery testing. It's still early days, but there are some results coming out of the testing with the lead crystal battery, which has obviously been finished, but I've now got the Victron Energy Gel battery. Now this Victron Energy Gel battery is obviously a good quality battery. I know they are very particular on the products that they sell. The gel batteries are certainly more robust than standard lead acid by all accounts. And a lot of people, there were some comments saying that perhaps a lead crystal battery was a gel battery in disguise, but let me just reveal some stats to you anyway. So the testing of the lead crystal battery, that battery that I tested, it was a 22 amp hour battery. I was testing it at a current of around 4 or just over 4 amps. So it's roughly around 20% C. So 20% of its capacity rating is what I was testing it at. It, at maximum, at one point was producing 26 amp hour down to zero. And at minimum, this is after about 2 or 3 months of testing and leaving it discharged for a period of 1 month, it was still able to produce 23 amp hour of capacity. So that basically was a loss of about 12% of its capacity over with some severe abuse. However, it was always able to produce 11 amp hour, so 50% of its rated capacity, which is what I recommend, at around 12 volts, even after all the abuse. Now the gel battery, it's 110 amp hour, but at one point it did produce about 123, 125 amp hour. As I found both with the lead crystal and the gel, when I initially started off, I didn't get full capacity, taking it down to zero. After about the fourth or fifth charge discharge, it's kind of got to its maximum capacity. And so that was around, say, 123, 125 amp hour. But now, and the charge rate, the discharge rate is 10 amps is what I'm discharging at. So that's basically less than 10% of the rated capacity. So less intense than I did with the actual lead crystal battery. And that has already dropped in terms of its capacity to around 100 to 103 amp hour. So it's already lost in 14 cycles, so just 2 weeks of testing, 17% of its of the capacity. So it's early days, but it certainly seems like it's taking a punishment. I did leave it discharged for 3 days at one point to give it a bit of a knacking, like I did with the lead crystal, but it still hasn't had as hard a time as a lead crystal, and the capacity is disappearing. But anyway, that's an ongoing test, and we'll see how that develops. Then what we're going to do, so the next thing I'm going to do is unpack the bits and pieces out of this box now. It'll be a bit awkward. I'm going to kind of put the camera up in the one corner and just focus down and talk to you as I pull things out of this box. We're then also afterwards going to go to the bench, and I'm going to show you a measuring device or a measurement instrument that I got from Frankie Tong. And again, thanks to Frankie Tong, I purchased this from him. This was brought to my attention by Sean B, so it's a very good viewer and participant who's based up in Durban. When I did that tutorial on how to check the value of a zener diode, and he said, well, Frankie's got a device that can do that. And he pointed me to this. I'm not even going to try and pronounce the name. It's an odd name. It comes in like this, like Tupperware box. And at the end of the day, I need to learn how to use this, but I'll explain all about that when I get it down to the bench and just give you a quick overview.
Right, so you're gonna have to excuse the groovy camera work and angle. It's a big heavy box, I cannot put it onto the bench. Again, hats off to Barry, because he sent this, I think, in the middle of last week, and we're at the beginning of this week, and it's arrived here, but it was brought by UPS. So anyway, let's just go and have a look. So these are the mats which I'll be actually using on the bench, which have obviously got YouTube and MJ Lawton and tester.co.uk. So these will be used when I do reviews. And then the bigger ones will probably be used in the background, particularly of the new lab in the States. He's also sent a whole lot of catalogs. So that's interesting. So it's always nice to have something in print these days. I know everything is done online, but they've certainly got a lot of test equipment, including leads. So a lot of test leads, and hopefully in the future, and a lot of tools. So that is something that we'll be looking at in the future as well. Heavens, he sent a lot of catalogs. Right, so the first unit here is the UT240, and it's a power and harmonics clamp meter. So there was a few clamp meters that caught my eye, and I said, ultimately, this isn't to say that this is necessarily the best equipment, and that's why it's here. We're here to review it, to understand, and that's where your input is going to be valuable. I will review it and give my point of view, and if you happen to have tested this equipment yourself or have an opinion, post it, because this is the kind of feedback that Barry's looking for. Certainly a nice solid case. Heavens, it's not a small beast by any means. So it's got the batteries. Wow, certainly a nice case, nice packaging inside, and a nice big beast. Now, there is a reason. So the reason that this caught my eye, it's a power meter. So it looks like you can put in up to 3 voltages, so you can do 3 phase. The bit of guessing going on here. It's got, I can't recall whether this one had some data logging, but it can measure power, and that's what caught my eye. So again, we'll certainly have a look at this. It also does remote data logging to a PC by all accounts as well. Right, the next item. This is the UT300 series infrared thermometers. So these are just handheld thermometers, they're not thermal images. Barry has thermal images, and again, once I get to the States, that is something I certainly would like to own myself. It would save me from going holding bits of wire and yelping all the time it's hot if I'm doing that testing. Certainly, you must say, nice cases. And here we go. Quite a big instrument. It looks, you can actually put in an external K-type probe by the looks of things. And as far as I remember, this one can actually save data measurements that you've actually got as well. It's obviously got the laser pointer as well. So again, another piece of kit that we'll have a look at. It also has, so you can actually connect to a PC and download data by all accounts as well. So the one thing I want to highlight with all this, one really handy thing, and I want to say hats off to Barry for putting his money where his mouth is and actually dropping all this kit in my hands. I'm fairly certain with the amount of kit that I'm going to receive from Barry, I am going to have too much. Okay. There's, you know, so here is the potential for many more giveaways. If people are interested in this kit and are excited about it, then potentially, again, once I get to the States, there will be loads of giveaways of equipment like this, which will be sponsored by Barry. Okay, and here we go. This is a UT800 series bench-type digital multimeter. Now, I'm going to be very honest about this one. I think I've seen this prior to Barry obviously sending me the list. And when I saw it, I thought, ugh, that just doesn't look really good at all. Why on earth? It's not really high resolution. It doesn't look fancy at all. I'm going to open this box now so we can have a quick look. But I thought, oh, as it's in the list, rather than me have a prejudicially judge it by kind of the specs on the internet, let me get into my hands and see if it's going to surprise me. So for this to kind of walk away with a good review, it really is going to have to surprise me, because I think this might be one that's not the best. But nonetheless, we'll review it. So here we go. It's a bench multimeter. I forget the resolution. It's not very high. And I think there are quite a few, there are many handheld multimeters which would probably outdo the performance of this. But it's a prejudiced statement. We will do the review and actually see. Perhaps it's a handy device to have on the bench because it's powered. Does it download data? It does. It has got USB and RS-232. So again, I don't want to be too prejudicial in the statement. Heavens, and I can see. I'm going to have to test this one here, because this one is literally power rated for 200 to 240 volt, which, well, I might on my bench in the US. I'll probably have a step up transformer so that I can power devices like this. But there you go. This will be one which will be for review soon. It's got a switch for DC or AC. So there you go. Right, and another clamp meter. This is a UT200 series digital clamp meter. And so another nice case, a set of leads. And this unit, as I recall, is a little more basic than the other one. Again, I'm kind of speaking off the top of my head. Has actually got the batteries in it already. And this one, why did I choose it? Oh, it's an AC and a DC clamp meter. So again, it'll be one that we have a look at and we'll see if it's any good. Heavens above. Okay, so quite a few pieces of equipment. Oh, I think there might be one more stuck in here. I'll have to have a look. So the one thing obviously I wanted, because I said my experience with LCR meters is fairly limited, on the list was this LCR meter. So I thought, brilliant, because I want devices. I am, when I get to the States, I'm going to buy a fairly expensive reference bench meter for doing LCR, so at least I do have a reference, so at least I can start judging the other bits of equipment. But here's one by Uniti. I think some people have already said that perhaps, I'm not too sure whether it's this one, but certainly one of the Uniti meters isn't the best. This is a UT610, but again, we'll see when we have it on for review. So here you go, a separate battery. It's got the, I think that's for SMD devices, the kind of tweezers. It's got one of these little Uniti adapters, so that obviously you can plug your devices for test straight into here as opposed to using the leads. And there you go. So another LCR meter, so we can actually do a comparison with these devices soon. Okay, last on the list, this is also on his list, and as I don't actually have one, and I thought it might be handy, this is a laser distance meter. So perhaps not quite the norm in terms of electronic measurement equipment, but although nonetheless, a quick little review on this might be interesting to see whether it adds any value or not. I know that there are other big brands like Fluke who do devices like this as well. But here we go, it's in the box, so we'll certainly have a quick peek at this at some point in time and see how well it works. Heavens, okay. So just as well, he didn't send me 40 items. There's 6 items sitting over there because there wouldn't be space left for me in the lab. But again, hats off and thank you to Barry. I'm sure there are many of you would kind of be overjoyed to do the kind of work that I do, where you can just get a buzz at the door and get a load of test equipment to kind of look at and play at. And I do. I count myself very fortunate. I can officially say at this point in time, this is kind of my work going forward. It provides an income for me, and I do. I count myself very fortunate. I have hit this point. There are opportunities for other people to do the same thing. There's nothing particularly special about me. As you know, I'm a novice, and I'm learning along the way. But Barry, and I'll just mention it, Barry has said that he is looking for testers and people to do written reviews for their site who are based in the UK. So I put that out there. If you are interested, then certainly you can pop me an email or post on my forum, and I will let Barry know. Obviously, there will be a limited number of people that are involved. Obviously, it's not for free. He will actually supply the piece of equipment. The arrangements and negotiations in terms of that will have to be done with Barry, but there is an opportunity there to potentially have equipment coming to your front door which you can sit and play with and review. Right, with all that done, let's get down to the bench and have a look at the little device that Frankie Tong sent me. Right here, so this is the device that was sent to me by Frankie. Comes in this box that says field measuring instruments, and the company you do it obviously do a few. They've got a digital insulation resistance tester, analog insulation resistance tester, and then this one, the transistor tester. I did note, I mean, they've got some obviously pictures on the top there. I did note when I put the batteries in that the battery compartment on this takes 4 AA batteries, but there's place for another 2. So they're obviously kind of, this is a hybrid box in which they house all those devices and obviously just put the electronics in for whichever device. So this is the label on the top of the device here. I'm not even going to try and pronounce the name. It does come with this carry case and this manual. The manual, unfortunately, really is written in, obviously, someone whose mother tongue, I presume, is Chinese. So obviously, their writings in English is not the best. And they refer to a picture. Now, I mean, there's a picture over here, but they kind of refer to a picture where stating where you connect things. And that doesn't seem to be there. I'm very wary. I'm going to take my time learning how to use this. The reason being, this device, and I'll just bring you a little closer, this device, as you can see, it's here, it can test PNP and NPN transistors. It can test your 7800 series voltage regulators, which get plugged in over here. It does a voltage test for capacitors as well. It's got several sockets where you can obviously, you've got emitter, base, collector, and then the repeated inputs over here. It can test, it's got 1000 volts noted over here, but in the manual it actually says on that test it will test, you can do insulation testing. So recently, you know, I've done the few tutorials on wires heating up and wire gauge. Now, as I said, the one important thing on wiring is the insulation to contain high voltages. And so for insulation testing, particularly whether it's with
Portable appliances, which is a big thing in the UK, which tester.co.uk also specialise in, or your house wiring, is to test that there's no leakage or little leakage in the wiring and the insulation. And so you can pump a high DC voltage through it within reason. There's lots of things you have to be wary about doing that. And this apparently can do that. So because it can kick out a high DC voltage, one has to be very careful how you handle this and use it. So I certainly have a lot more reading to do and understanding to make sure, because obviously the manual's not that well written, to see how it works. Once I've sussed it out and I feel I've got a reasonable understanding, I'll then perhaps do a little review on this and then go back to the little tutorial on how to test Zener diodes. Because this can obviously produce enough voltage to test a whole host of diodes, whether they're LEDs, normal diodes, or Zener diodes, even the ones with high voltages. So thanks again to Frankie, the kind man who's very resourceful, for sending this to me. So this is something certainly, again, very different, and we'll have a closer look at soon.
Okay, so thanks again for watching this video. Please, if you gain any value or you enjoy following the stuff that I'm doing, it's always great to get a thumbs up, and if you can share it, that really does help as well. Please don't forget, remember the link below for the PDK competition, the Portable Dog Killer competition. Please go down there, go to the forum, read through the submissions. They've been absolutely brilliant. And then vote for the person who you enjoy most, their kind of entry or their device, and then post a note below this video with their forum ID, their membership ID, and then we'll tally up those votes. So again, I thank you very much, and I'll catch you soon for the next video. Cheers.
Tester.co.uk